We are returning to the ring for some fun, except we're not returning to a ring.
We're going to a Japanese bathhouse.
Yay! Woo! Japanese bathhouses.
Look, it's that nice thing about the wacky world of wrestling. There's lots of things under one umbrella. And this is an example of something that was tried once and actually twice and never done again.
Really?
Yeah, two things done. They were both filmed on the same day.
Oh, were they?
Yeah,
right?
In the same place.
I see, yeah.
Yeah, it's very much a cost-cutting exercise.
Yeah.
Something that WrestleMe would never do.
No.
We record all shows the day before transmission. Individually.
In full.
That is why we can tell you that in the news, Pete, you're going to have to insert this on the day.
Yeah.
Let us remember both Her Majesty the Queen, the late Queen, and Princess Diana by talking about the FMW bathhouse match.
So I am familiar with the Japanese bathhouse, the onsen, if you will.
Right.
They are very particular about who they let in.
Are they?
You're not allowed to go in with visible tattoos.
Yep, that's got connections with Japanese organised
yakuza,
crime.
Stuff like that, yeah. And you're just not allowed to play the giddy goat.
Are you not?
Explain to me, Pete,
how Headhunter A and B, Tarzan Goto and Mr. Gannosuke, managed to get
Mr. Gannosuke.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
It's a name that, again, I've never actually heard, and I only ever see it written down. Right. I would have thought it was Mr. Gannosuke, but I'm absolutely wrong.
It is Gannosuke, isn't it? I didn't look.
I probably know it from the IWA English commentary of King of the Deathmatch.
Right.
He's in one of the early ones.
Right,
I think they just sort of go, here he is, Mr. Gannosuke, and it'll be exactly the same as if we'd have done the commentary
and not thought
about it before.
Just kept flipping back and forth, going, how did they get into that room? How did this happen? So what's happening here, Matt?
So this takes place inside a traditional Japanese bathhouse. There is a ring, and it's a tag team match, and you might not have understood the part where two of the wrestlers go and sit in a hot tub.
Yeah.
The others wrestle, and there's occasional cutaways to a man stoking a boiler, right? He's a very thin man, and he's like powering up a fire. Now, the way this match worked was you would have a wrestling match, and your partners would sit inside the hot tub.
Right.
And as they sat there, the heat would be increased underneath them until it was boiling hot. And if they got out, they got a yellow card.
Right.
And if you got too many yellow cards, then you essentially are disqualified and the other team have won. Now, that might not sound like a good idea for a match. And watching this, it isn't. But what this bit has is a lot of bits of sort of Japanese sports humour.
Yeah.
So the two wrestlers, you don't really even see very much of the wrestling. I think it starts with Tarzan Goto and a headhunter in the tubs. There's a great bit where they're sitting next to each other, and as Goto gets in, he just splashes one of them, and he looks over and he's going, I'll splash you back. It's really like, you know, is this the best we can do? We're splashing each other. There's, you know, just, I mean, it's mental. This is exactly the sort of thing that would have been shown on one of those Clive James shows about Japan.
Oh yeah, it would be on Eurotrash. They occasionally went to Japan, I believe.
This match actually took place the day after their traditional King of the Deathmatch tournament.
Right. Okay.
So these guys did really, really horrible, hard death matches, and then this one was just a sort of bit of light fun, a bit of light relief.
Well, calm their sores down in the bath. Just leave a lot of blood behind.
They're just men in there, sort of like shampooing their own hair. And then they'll sort of like barrel through, and there's a bit of wrestling, and there's a bit where they go into a ladies' changing room.
Yeah.
And there are some boobies.
Yeah.
And the ladies go, woo! And the wrestlers roll about for a bit. This match is absolutely mystifying.
I don't know why they did it. I don't know how they were allowed to do it, because, you know, onsens are very, they're very prissy about what they're going to be allowing you to do in there. You certainly can't bust in and check out the ladies' knocks.
No. Well, the other one that they filmed on the same day developed this theme a bit.
Oh.
And this is annoyingly, Pete, because we watched the first one.
Right.
This is known as the better of the bathhouse matches in existence. It was a Shoji Nakamaki versus I'm thinking of the ladies in the changing room overheating. It was Shoji Nakamaki and Keisuke Yamada versus the same team of Tarzan Goto and Mr. Gannosuke. In that one, they develop the ladies a bit more, and there's a recurring theme where the wrestlers will hurt the other one by pressing them into a lady's bottom. King of sports.
Was this how their Attitude Era got going? Is that the Japanese equivalent of the Attitude
this
Era?
This is early. I mean, in 95, we've basically still got Duke the Dumpster Drosy in WWE. Over in FMW, Goto and Gannosuke are motorboating people on three women who are laughing. It is absolutely... Again, this is one of those things that I think, what is my nightmare? And my nightmare is me saying on this podcast, you know, when wrestling is at its finest, it's one of the great art forms. It's very misunderstood. And someone going, then how do you explain
this?
And it's the FMW second bloody bathhouse match. It's not an edifying spectacle.
No.
But at the end of the match, the wrestlers actually spill out onto the street. It's always nice to see Japanese streets. You don't
yes,
see enough
yeah,
of them.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely like the 90s as well.
Just a little sort of like normal neighbourhood. But it ends with the two victorious wrestlers walking off into the sunset with the three scantily clad ladies. So it's a really sort of basic form of storytelling that it's such a weird, strange match. They actually marketed this as a videotape.
Right.
And it became sort of quite notorious, as in
it was so bizarre.
Mm. It was just so bizarre. And this is from a company that, I mean, they actually had a couple of matches, FMW, where the aim was to stick an explosive up your opponent's bum. So,
they're very toilet humoury, are the Japanese.
I tell you who else is toilet humoury. Yeah. Vince McMahon.
Oh.
That's his big thing. He loves people being hit with potties in hospital. He loves people pretending to shit themselves. Again and again, the WWE, most recently with a guy called Drake Maverick, they are obsessed with urination and people publicly wetting themselves.
Really?
That is really Vince McMahon's absolute like sweet spot. I often think when we end up working for WWE, our first thing is we're going to say we want to do this big thing. It's going to be with whoever is the champion, whoever is the number one contender.
Yeah.
And one of them's going to do one of them's going to kiss a poo. And Vince McMahon will go, whatever you guys are on, it's doubled. What a silly match.
And then his quads explode. He's sat down.
Yeah, I know what you're going to be doing over Christmas. You are going to be treating yourself to that on a loop.
You're showing my dad it, going, look at this, Dad. I've already said it like three or four people, going, look at this.
I wonder if that's ever happened in human history before.
What, just somebody climbing
that someone has just been walking
out,
and their legs have just gone poing.
Blown out both of his quads, though. That's such a... Because he walks so strangely anyway.
Yeah, you know who's...
He walks like he shat himself.
You know his who stole that walk?
Who?
Conor McGregor.
Oh yeah, he does kind of walk.
Conor McGregor
with his funny arms.
Absolutely
yeah.
Took it from Vince McMahon. Ah. He's openly admitted that. Yeah. He likes Vince's chutzpah. Yeah. I like it. I like it when the old man leg go twang. Who doesn't, Conor?
Who doesn't? We enjoyed that one in a kind of weird way.
I mean,
give it a watch.
It's
on YouTube
things.
And it's got boobs in it. That's not allowed. I tried uploading before. I got a copyright strike and also a Naughty Boy strike.
Really?
No, I'm just saying.
Did you show your boobs off on YouTube?
I showed my boobs off.
I thought this was Snapchat. It's worth seeing because it's just one of those weird sort of curios of wrestling. Mm. You will see it and you will go, that sounded fun and it wasn't as much fun as it should have been.
Yeah.
But, you know, hey, look, you can't win them all. I've got your Christmas prezzy.
You always are very good with the old Christmas presents.
You're the best. You're the best present giver I've ever met, and I say that absolutely. I didn't wrap it because that would have taken time. But this is not just a Christmas present to you. This is a Christmas present for all of the Wrestle Me Marks.
The Wrestle Me Marks. What is this now? Best in the world. Is this some kind of CM Punk?
This is very much part one of your CM Punk cosplay, Pete. I have got you an old original CM Punk Best in the World t-shirt.
Yes!
As he wore during his successful WWE Championship run. All you need now is a little pair of black Speedos.
A little tape around my hands.
Yep. Yeah. I think that would be a wonderful gift for all the Pat Patreonsons to finally see how convincing you are dressed as CM Punk.
Because people talk a good game when you see a man with a receding hairline and a widow's peak, and they go, CM Punk.